Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where we talk about skincare, grooming, sometimes hair. So if that sounds like your thing, make sure you are subscribed. But today we're bringing back the Skincare 101 series where we go through every single step of the skincare routine so you can decide what steps are ready for you. So we are about halfway through the routine now. So today we're tackling essences and serums, so kind of a two-in-one, and you'll see why I'm doing these together. So let's get into it. What is a serum? A serum is a very concentrated gel-like treatment for your skin. Usually the molecules in a serum are tiny, like super small, so they're able to penetrate the skin and absorb super quick. This means the ingredients in a serum can offer benefits deeper within the skin rather than just kind of like the top layers, like say a moisturizer would. You may also have heard the term ampoule. This is basically like a supercharged intense serum. So these are kind of like recommended almost like a prescription kind of way. So for example, every day I'll use a serum, but say I'm breaking out and I really need to concentrate on getting rid of this breakout, what I'll do is I'll use an ampoule whose job it is to target my breakouts, and I'll use that until I'm happy with the state of my skin again. So when should you use a serum? So serums are typically used after the essence, before your moisturizer. However, nowadays you get very thick essences, you get super watery serums, so depending on what you have, you should always start with the lighter product first, then it gets heavier. And serums you can usually use twice a day depending on the serum, so morning and night, but do read the packaging, of course, as always, where it always tell you what to not mix it with, for example, and when you can and can't use it. But typically twice a day, morning and night, if you want to. So why should you use a serum? Serums are personally one of my favorite things to use in the skincare routine, among many, many others. But serums can really, really help with particular skin concerns where other products can't. And there are a lot of choices when it comes to a serum. There's serums designed specifically for anti-aging, for breakouts, oil control, skin brightening, adding moisture. There really is a serum for everyone. And as I mentioned, the molecules in serums are tiny, so they're able to penetrate the skin better and actually give you amazing results. So if you are struggling with your skin a little bit, say you do your basic cleanse, tone, moisturize, but maybe you've got dark spots that you want to get rid of, or maybe your skin's looking a little bit dull, adding in a serum for that specific need, for that specific concern, is really going to take your skincare to the next level. So who can use a serum? What skin types can use a serum? Everyone, basically, because there's a serum for everyone and everything and every concern, like I keep saying. There are hundreds and thousands of different serums. Well, maybe that's going too far. There's a lot. So yes, it really depends on what your skin is needing, what your skin is craving, what it's asking for. I'm gonna share two of my favorite serums with you now. So if you have very sensitive or stressed out skin, whether that's irritated from dryness or irritated from acne or spots, whether you want to improve the appearance of your skin tone, the texture of your skin, this serum really does do a lot. And this is because it's the Centella Blemish Ampoule. And this is great for people with oily and dehydrated skin as well. Even dry skin, it really helps your natural moisture to kind of like control itself. Control sebum production without ripping out all your natural oils. Yes, and keeps you nice and hydrated but not oily. This really is a good all-rounder. I don't want to go too far into Centella because I think I'm doing a video on that soon. But it really is kind of like the new fad ingredient that everyone's putting in into their skincare, but for a good reason. My second favorite, which I think I mention all the time, is the Body Shop Tea Tree Anti-Imperfection Solution. This is great for when you're breaking out, for oily prone skin as well. Tea tree is often quite a drying ingredient and can be quite harsh, but in this form here, it's not drying, it's actually quite moisturizing. It's really, really good at getting rid of your breakouts, as well as blemished skin as well, so any dark spots that you get. What I love about this is when I do have spots, when I'm using this, they won't leave me with dark spots. So this is a really, really good one. Serums are super easy to use and they always usually come with a dropper. I will recommend applying these horizontally onto your face so you don't get that annoying drip down your face. Then all you do is pat in your serum. So obviously I'm doing serums and essences together, but why? That is because a lot of people say they're basically the same thing. Are they the same thing? Kind of. Maybe, yes, but there's a reason I'd highly recommend using both. So first of all, what is an essence? So an essence is traditionally a very light, liquidy type product that traditionally contains fermented ingredients to help kind of speed up your skin's cell turnover. This means that essences are traditionally used, that word keeps coming up, traditionally used for combating the signs of aging. So fine lines, wrinkles, dark spots, whilst improving the appearance of your skin in general. So brightening, evening out your skin tone, generally making your skin look a lot more awake and alive. When should you use an essence? Essences are typically used after a toner or even in place sometimes of a toner and before a serum. But again, that really does depend on the thickness of your product. Again, nowadays, essences can be just as thick as a cream, thicker than a serum even. So again, it depends on that thickness. You can use serum and essences interchangeable. But when we're talking about the traditional essences, the watery essence, that comes after toner before a serum. You can use an essence twice a day as well, morning and night. People often take an essence and they'll spray it on their face throughout the day as well, just kind of refresh themselves. So why should you use an essence, especially if we're saying they're kind of the same as a serum? Well, if we're talking about an essence in its traditional sense of what an essence really is, as I mentioned, they target everything from anti-aging to dark spots. So they're a really good product to use on a daily basis just to kind of like target the overall look of your face. And you do start to see a really obvious visual improvement on your skin. So who can use an essence? Once again, everyone can use an essence. Anti-aging and correcting the tone of your skin isn't limited to one skin type, but also the ingredients in a traditional essence really is for everyone. People with oily skin will find that it gives a nice glow, it refreshes the skin, it also makes your skin feel nice and nourished without that feeling of like heavy moisture on your face. Whereas people with dry skin, on, you know, completely opposite to oily skin, will find that this adds a boost of moisture. Essences can also help retain moisture, as well as get rid of any irritation that dry skin may be feeling. So it really is for everyone on every spectrum. So my favorite essence of all time ever, because it's actually one of the only ones I've used, and I didn't realize, and I'll tell you why, is the Time Revolution First Treatment Essence, and this is by Misha. As I mentioned, it's one of the only ones I've used by accident, because I didn't realize I was buying like the same one, just in different packaging. But it is amazing. Again, it's got that fermented yeast in it, which is perfect at targeting pretty much everything and improving the look of everything. Essences, again, are super easy to use. I actually have a spray-on version, so I just spritz that on my face and then pat that in. If you don't have the spritz-on version, again, just pour some into your hand, kind of do this. So it's on your hands and then again, pat in. So do you need to use both an essence and a serum? Is it a waste of money? Well, short answer, no, you don't need to use both. Long answer, like maybe I would, I do. So this is how I personally see an essence and a serum and why I use both of them. For me, an essence is a daily use product. Like I'll cleanse every day, I'll tone every day, I'll use an essence every day. And this is because it targets things that are always a concern for my skin. So I want the overall appearance of my skin to improve and I want the anti-aging properties of an essence. I want that every day, no matter what the condition of my skin is. Whereas a serum really depends on what my skin needs that day, that week, that month. So a serum is always changing. So an essence will cover everyday concerns and a serum will target my skin's specific needs for that day or week. But you do get essences that target something completely different. For example, this green tea watery essence is all about moisture. So maybe you are younger and you want to use an essence that gives you moisture, but then you'll find a serum that gives you moisture as well. So I would say if you are younger and you're not too worried about anti-aging stuff, just go with a serum that targets your overall needs. The marketing and manufacturing of essences and serums have changed drastically, even within the last year, 2 years, and they've pretty much become the same thing. As I said, you'll find essences that are almost like a cream, you'll find serums that are pretty much water. So if you're not going with the traditional essence and serum, you don't really need both. But I do hope I was able to explain why I use both and kind of help you guys decide if these steps are really for you. Do check out the other videos in the Skincare 101 series. We've done SPF already, because I kind of did that before I started the series, cleanser and toner and exfoliators. So next up, I guess we are on the moisturizers. Then I guess we'll go into extras like masking. What else is there? And other things. But that is it for me now, guys. I will see you next time.